Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Sage 2023 Showcase, and apparently the audio level does not save. That's okay, I fixed it. This time we're checking out Quill Framework, which, hold on, stop the presses for a bit. Yeah, pull this up. There we go. I pulled that up. Anyways, this is actually not technically a game. This is from the last category on the Sage website, which is the engines category. I decided to check out a couple engines today for the Sage. Every single Sage showcase, there's always an engines category, which basically showcases a bunch of engines people have made through different game maker engines or other engines to basically allow people to make their own Sonic games, sometimes other types of games, more easily. Just basically preset engines to help consolidate polish and momentum, especially when it comes to like movement and stuff. So there's always new engines being released, and Quill Framework is one that I've not seen before. It's apparently, as it describes itself, a feature-rich, classic Sonic-inspired 2D framework for the Unity engine. This framework was originally a fun sandbox project for the developer to learn how to program in C#. They didn't have an end goal in mind, but they think where it is right now is the perfect starting point for other people to use it. So, the main focus of the framework was to keep things as Unity as possible while being close to Sonic as he could. So, basically, if you understand Unity stuff like animator systems, 2D colliders, and all that other stuff, the project will make a lot of sense to you for making your own Sonic game through Unity. So, that's the idea of this engine, but it does indeed have gameplay. That's the reason we are checking it out, after all. It has an example, stage sets and stuff, so we're going to check that out, see what it's got, see how it plays. I'm maybe not the best person to review engines, because I personally do not develop with these engines, but nonetheless, it is interesting to show them off and let people know they exist. So that's why we are here. Of course, before we begin, if you like the video, do think about giving a like. If you haven't subscribed yet, think about doing that as well. But if you really want to help out, think about coming over to Twitch. We're trying to reach a partner over here, but we need more viewers to do that. So if you want to come by with a lurker to talk, think about doing so, because it does make a big difference, and we'd honestly love to have you. Also, we have a pretty cool Discord community, if you want to check that out. And I have a coffee link, if you want to help directly monetize my content. And I have a merch store, if you want to buy some cool stuff. Links are all in the description, you can check them out at your leisure. Don't mind me, I'm picky about the volume. You know what? That'll do, that is fine, that is good volume. But yeah, links in the description, go look at them if you want. And with that being said, by the way, yes, we have new emotes on the Twitch too, another reason to come by. I finally got follower emotes unlocked. They were locked down for the longest time because I personally think that they just fucked up with how my profile was supposed to work for a while. They finally like fixed it, so I have follower emotes now. I also added some new anime emotes as well as just a new static emote for tier 1 because I got a new slot for that. So there's a whole bunch of new emotes, and you can use them. Now that I have follower emotes, that basically means that even if you don't subscribe to my Twitch channel, you can still use my emotes just by following. So come on by and follow. But that being said, let's go ahead and check out this cool framework. So we have... what characters are available? The classic trio, which you know who I'm going to pick. All right, let's do it. Sirio. Good night, Sirio. Oh, right, look at Tails, he's so cool. Alright, I guess we're playing. Oh. Quasar Lake Zone, alright. You know, honestly, just for an example game to show off an engine, I like the vibes. There's a lot of demonstrated here. In, like, the cutscene, for instance, that was well done. I actually think this engine has a lot of use. Like, it's unfortunate the timing of this engine. Given what Unity did this year, it definitely has lost customers this year. But nonetheless, I understand that Unity is still a very popular engine, a lot of people use it. And I don't think you're a bad person if you use Unity, I understand. Like, a lot of people trained for a while to use Unity, so I don't feel like it's unreasonable if you keep using it after what they did earlier this year. So I think that, like, a Unity-based engine to make a Sonic, 2D Sonic game is a good idea. Like, that's actually... I'm pretty sure it's been done before. Pretty sure there have been Sonic-styled engines for Unity before, but I do believe those were older ones. So it's nice to have an updated version. Because I do think this will come in useful for somebody. There are tons of Sonic fan games out there, and I'm sure there's a lot of Unity developers who have the Unity skill set in mind, like they have used it, and they can make use of this. So far how it feels is okay. I feel like it's a little, there's some like a little bit of heaviness, I think, to the movement, but it feels pretty good overall. Like, if I played this, I would say I can feel that this is a fan game, right? It's not like 1-1 with like the classic games. But it doesn't feel bad. If I played a Sonic game using this engine, I'd be like, this is obviously a fan game, but it feels pretty good. Basically, it's got that fan game kind of feel to the controls. But that's not really a bad thing, you know? It's that thing where you're like, oh, I acknowledge this is not official, but like beyond that, it doesn't bother you, you know? Oh. I'll keep the fire shield. Oh, never mind then. Oh no, it just blew up. Okay. Tails, you're too fat! You fucking broke the bar but by standing on it for a while. Oh, cool. It also has... Alright, cool. I like the fact there's cutscenes to demonstrate the engine. A lot of times when we review these engines, it's just the stages. But we're being shown intro cutscenes, transition cutscenes. I like this. It's a better way to show off your engine than a lot. Give it some extra flourish. It also shows that the engine developer cares a bit more about their engine, too. Also, I don't know if this music is original for this engine. But I really do find this music quite nice, actually. Why are there so many robotic monitors? Yeah, it gives more examples to work with, too. Like, it just gives... Oh! Wait, no, you're kidding me. Is there actually... Huh! Okay, I think that's the first time an engine has had a special stage. Alright. I'm impressed. Okay, this is a little bit janky. But it's not too bad. Like, this could use a little polish, but it's not too bad. I feel like the movement, it was like really snappy. There was no momentum. Wow, Tails did really good. He got 4 Chaos Emeralds in one special stage. Tails is just an overachiever today. Why do I have 4? Still though, it's still a good little demonstration. Wait, I was just here. Why did I go back in? Man, I guess I get more rings. There we go. See, this is the reason I check out these engines. They're being provided to the public to demonstrate, here's an example. That's the thing, these example games are supposed to showcase the engine. Hence, shouldn't they be interesting? Shouldn't the example game do something interesting or demonstrate the engine well? That's the theory, at least. So when I see these engines, I'm like, I would like to play their example game because this should be the best foot forward, so to speak, of the engine. That's kind of an interesting way to do screws and springs. What does screws and springs sound like? Some weird variation of shoots and ladders. One thing I am noticing... I feel like everything... Like, the physics of this is just a little bit different than you'd expect. Oh my. I just realized those fish... are a little janky too. So this engine is definitely not finished, I'd say. It definitely needs more polish. It's got a little bit of jank here and there with momentum and physics. And those fish look pretty bad, actually. But I don't hate this engine either. I think it's doing some things right. It just feels like it needs a little more work. But it's on a right, it's on a good track, you know? Wait, so this engine is actually kind of overachieving though with the cutscenes of the special stage? Oh, ciao. That's cool. Sorry, there's a bonus stage. Alright. So it's gonna have a boss, isn't it? It's just gonna do a normal Sonic 1 boss. Oh, that's a bit different. Okay. I have to admit, I wasn't quite expecting that sort of rotation. It's not terribly interesting, but it is different. Oh, okay. Okay. The boss fights developed over time. That is a little bit... Okay, it's still a little simple. But I will give points for remixing a concept here. It does require some thought now. Yeah, the challenge sign. That's... Makes sense if he's trying to stay close to working in Unity. Yeah, that's true. You know, I kind of wonder if this music was composed for this engine example. Because I'm noticing these songs are actually, like this song we're hearing right now. Is a remix of one of the zone songs we just heard. Yeah, the same boss remix is a perfect example. I think this is not too bad. I do think it needs a little more polish. But I like the passion behind it. I could definitely pick up on what this engine is doing right. And there's quite a bit to it. Like Fepford helps. Interesting. Or at least it was an inspiration. Oh, it said Sega Sound, so maybe this music is from a Sega game? Oh, yes, I'm aware, the music got louder randomly. I think it reset my sound settings again. Oh well. Yep, there it is. So, I think it needs a little bit more polish, but I actually rather like it. I feel that some of the Sonic fan game engines that people have made seem kind of redundant. Like they were made for really old engines where you should probably just update to something else better than that. Rather than use that existing engine. But I do kind of feel like this one has more of a point being on Unity, which is very widespread. And especially if it's designed well for people who understand Unity, which there's a lot of people who do understand Unity. So I think this engine has way more of a purpose than a lot of the engines I've checked out. And I do think it needs a little more polish, but admittedly, at this point, handing it over to Unity developers, they could add that polish themselves at this point. Because it's more or less pretty solid. I think it's pretty good. I think this is an engine that actually has some real purpose, which I don't normally feel with these engines. So yeah, the Quill framework. I think this is a pretty good idea. I think the creator of this... should be proud of his work. I would recommend he continue to polish it up and release a patch where the physics and the movement and a few other little details are a little bit more polished up for a basic framework to start out with. But that's kind of nitpicks. This is pretty solid. Nicely done, the Quill framework. If you do use Unity and you're interested in making a Sonic fan game, maybe check this one out.